ex-wives, I can tell you that. Just before I get started, Hector was a living to the fact that quite a great pair of drivers Ronnie and Keith were. Hector holds a record that neither Ronnie and Keith ever came close to approaching. Hector came to Roosevelt years ago when I was there, and fortunately for me, I wasn't in the race. Because afterwards, Johnny Chapman said to him, "Well, heck, you did a hell of a job. You ran into all seven guys." Anyway, Dad was asked to stand up here and speak to me, and was very honored when Jack asked him to, because he's been great friends with Keith for many, many years, as well as Ronnie. But he said that's similar to asking him to play the piano. He doesn't do either. So I'm up here in his place. He and I were talking earlier about what a great guy Keith is, and just to show you what a wonderful fellow he is, he spent all week getting the okay from the staff up at Cushing Daisy's retirement home, getting a pass for Ronnie so he could attend. Anyway, fortunately or unfortunately, I'm old enough to remember Keith in his heyday. And as a matter of fact, I was 5 years old peering through the fence on the backstretch of Richland Park the night Keith won the Mighty Dudley in 59-3. And he was amazing, amazing talent, as a lot of the great drivers have stated over the years. And fortunately for me, I was able to compete against Keith over the years in a few state races and whatnot. And as we all know, Keith didn't always need the best horse to win. One of the funny stories my dad related to me was, I was grooming one of the horses that night. We ended up, there was only one division of the Grand Circuit Pace at Greenwood the 1 year. And Dad had a four-horse entry. And Keith drove Rome along for my father, and won, of course. And anyway, the Copus table ended up 1, 2, 3, 5. So when they're pulling up, Keith said, "Geez, we did all right." But he said, "Who was the idiot that left the one in between us?" And Dad looked over and said, "Me." Another story related to me was one time he and Keith were at Roosevelt racing, and I don't know the particulars of what went on after the races, but they were a little late getting up the next morning and had to hurry to the airport. Keith was driving when they arrived at LaGuardia, rather than go to the rental car return. Keith had pulled up at the front of LaGuardia Airport, jumped up, left the keys in the car, and slammed the door. And Dad said, "Keith, what about the car?" He said, "If they want it, they'll find it." So now I'm going to turn the mic over to my mother. I think she's got a few things she'd like to say. And it's wonderful to see the harness racing community come together again tonight like it has, for the Austin family. What a horrible tragedy. I thought Mark was not only a great horseman, but a great individual, always very friendly, and just a great, all-around great guy. Anyway, thank you all for coming tonight, and here's Mom.
Anyway, congratulations, Eileen. I think you deserve some accolades.